Today is the history every girl should know. Today is the history every woman should prize. Do you know Sati? Sati is a practice among Hindu communities where a recently widowed woman, either voluntarily or by force, sacrifices herself by sitting atop her deceased husband's funeral pyre. Don't you think of it as a barbaric practice? But people consider it as devotion. The Rajput women burnt themselves after their men were defeated in battles to avoid being taken by the victors. Do you know the recent Sati instance? It took place in Madhya Pradesh in 2006 when Janak Rani sacrificed herself willingly. And a 65-year-old woman did the same thing in Madhya Pradesh in 2002. In Rajasthan in 1987, 18-year-old Roop Kuvarba Kanwar was forcibly burnt alive to death. Sati practice is not just to show women devotion towards her deceased husband. It shows the fear of parents and society to take care of the widow. After husband's death, she was considered burdensome. She was outcasted. She had to shave heads and drape white sari. She needs to be dependent and abandoned. So, widows choose to die rather than live a life of hell. Many people tried to stop this feat, fighting for several years. Many acts were passed, but women still practiced Sati, which were not officialized. The two best solutions for abolishing Sati are 1. Girl education, so that widow can be knowledgeable against such evil practices and be fearless and independent doing some work even after husband's death. 2. Widow remarriage, so that she will again have responsibilities and reasons to live and can have a shoulder to support and share. There are many eminent people in India like Mahatma Jyotiba Phule, Savitribai Phule, Mahadev Govind Ranade, Raja Ramohan Rai, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar who fought for girl education and widow remarriage. One among them is Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar. He supported women's education, and as a result of his efforts, many girls' schools were established in Kolkata. At that time, the condition of widows in Hindu society was very terrible. He prepared the Lokmat for widow remarriage. With his efforts, the widow remarriage law was passed in 1856. He also opposed child marriage. He is not the one who fought for change, but also brought the change by marrying his son to a widow. Remembering Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar's contributions to women education and widow remarriage on his birth anniversary. And hail to all those people who supported and shaped our women.
Follow us on Facebook and Instagram and subscribe us on YouTube at Ragashree Video.